That's our indication that the automation has been engaged and come into life, so we no longer have hands on the steering wheel. The vehicle's driving itself at this point.
Over the last few days, we've had the opportunity to showcase automated vehicle which is capable of driving in particularly dynamic and complex scenarios.
Traffic incident reported ahead.
Manual traffic controller has us stopped here for a minute while the tow truck gets in place, and now they're waving us through. So we got the wave through. Vehicle checks to make sure it's okay to proceed, and it does. Gets into the lane, and we pass the tow truck. And eventually we'll switch back into our original lane of travel.
It's real important to establish how automated vehicles should interact in these scenarios, because they're some of the really difficult challenges that as an industry we're still struggling to solve in order to ensure that as automated vehicles come into to proliferate the roadway system, we are indeed ready from a safety perspective to ensure that we're making the road safer for all individuals, but particularly for public services.
So now we have a police officer that's behind us in our rear view. Oh, they want to make contact with us. The blue lights are on.
Emergency vehicle activity detected from behind, yielding. Pulling over for emergency vehicle.
Right now, our vehicle is looking for a safe space to merge onto the shoulder for the traffic stop.
With this demonstration, we're trying to show some solutions for how automated vehicles can interact with public safety. That includes fire, EMS, law enforcement, in a safe and effective way. There's a window display that's like a touchscreen that a law enforcement officer could use to get information about the vehicle, including things like license, registration, and insurance. And so we're trying to figure out ways to do that to make both the police officer feel safe, make the interaction very efficient, but also the occupants of the vehicle will have a good understanding of what's going on.
Emergency vehicle contact has concluded. Resuming trip.
Taking the ominous out of autonomous. So letting folks know, both the driving public, the riding public, and folks that might interact with these vehicles in the not too distant future, on a larger scale, let them know that the automakers, the OEMs, and partners like we have with VTTI and other partners as part of the SOADS project are taking those scenarios into consideration from the very get-go.
The live environment is so much more complex with additional traffic, and so getting it out in the real world, demonstrating it, getting people in the seats to help experience it as well is definitely a positive thing. And we get those stakeholders giving us feedback so that we can make the concepts better and make recommendations about best practices.
Vehicles can only see so much of what's around them. So we have a lot of, like, the transurban express lanes that are highly instrumented roads that can provide additional context to the automated vehicle, whether there's a work zone ahead, an incident.
So automated vehicles are no longer just the story of science fiction. Thanks to technological advancements in things like processing and sensing, we really are ready to deploy from a technology standpoint these vehicles. Where it gets really challenging is setting the right expectations, policies, procedures, and really the best practices for overcoming unusual scenarios that happen on the roadway really all the time.